With DoubtNit, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry, and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question, and get instant video solution. Download DoubtNit app today.
Hello friends. So in this question, it is given that if sine inverse x plus sine inverse y is equals to pi by 2, then prove that cos inverse x is equals to sine inverse y. Second is that prove that sine 1 by 2 cos inverse 4 upon 5 is equals to 1 upon root 10. And my third part is that prove that 10 1 by 2 into cos inverse root 5 by 3 is equals to 3 minus root 5 by 2. Okay, so here I will take my first part. So my first part is given that sine inverse x plus sine inverse y is equals to pi by 2. Okay, so here I know a formula that my sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. Okay, so here my sine inverse x minus pi by 2 will be equals to minus cos inverse x. Okay, I have taken pi by 2 this side and cos inverse x that side. So here this equation can be written as what? Sine inverse x, take this minus pi by 2 this side, plus sine inverse y equals to 0. Okay, now at the place of sine inverse x minus pi by 2, you will put minus cos inverse x. So minus cos inverse x plus sine inverse y is equals to 0. Okay, now take cos inverse x that side, so you will get sine inverse y equals to cos inverse x. Okay, so here you can see that this only I have to prove, that cos inverse x is equals to sine inverse y, and here I have proved. Okay, so here I can write hence proved. Okay, now my second part. So in second part it is given that sine 1 by 2 cos inverse 4 by 5 is equals to 1 upon root 10. Okay, so here let's solve it. So my second part is given that sine 1 by 2 cos inverse 4 upon 5 is equals to 1 upon root 10. I have to prove this. So here I will take my LHS. So in LHS part, 1 by 2 cos inverse 4 upon 5. Okay, I will put this part equals to theta. Okay, so here you will get cos inverse 4 upon 5 equals to 2 theta. And here I can write that my cos 2 theta will be equals to 4 upon 5. Okay, now here I know what. Here I got cos theta equals to 4 upon 5. Now my cos theta equals to 1 minus 2 sine square theta by identity, which is equals to 4 upon 5. So here I will write 1 minus 4 upon 5 is equals to, I am taking this 4 upon 5 this side and this 2 sine square theta that side. So here when you take LCM, you will get 1 upon 5. Okay, 5 minus 4 upon 5 will be 1 upon 5, and your 2 will be come down, and this will be sine square theta. So sine theta will be equals to root 1 upon 10 will be formed. Okay, root 1 upon 10. So here you can see that my sine theta is coming root 1 upon 10. So from this my theta will be what? My theta will be sine inverse 1 upon root 10. Okay, now in this equation what I have taken? I have taken this part equals to theta. So here my LHS is what? Sine theta, it means that at the place of theta, I will put this value sine inverse 1 upon root 10. Okay, so my sine and sine inverse will cut, and here I will get 1 upon root 10. And my RHS is only this. Okay, so here I can write that my LHS is equals to RHS. Okay, hence proved. Now my third part. Okay, so here you can see that in third part it is given that prove that 10 1 by 2 cos inverse root 5 by 3 is equals to 3 minus root 5 by 2. Okay, so let's solve here. So it is given that 10 1 by 2 cos inverse root 5 by 3. We have to prove this part equals to 3 minus root 5 by 2. Okay, whole upon 2. So here what I will do, again I will put this part, okay, equals to theta. Okay, so here I will get cos inverse root 5 by 3 equals to 2 theta. It means what? That my cos 2 theta will be equals to root 5 by 3. Okay, now here it is 10. Okay, so I have to convert this part in the form of 10. Okay, and my cos theta is equals to 1 minus 10 square theta upon 1 plus 10 square theta equals to root 5 by 3. Okay, so here what I will do, here this part I will cross multiply. So after cos multiply, here I will get what? Here I will get 3 minus 3 10 square theta will be equals to root 5 plus root 5 10 square theta. Now take 10 square theta one side and other terms one side. So 3 minus root 5, it is equals to 3 10 square theta plus root 5 10 square theta. Okay, now here my 10 square theta is there, and from this I can write what? 10 square theta can be taken common. So here I will get 3 plus root 5, and here it is 3 minus root 5. Okay, so you will take this in denominator, so my 10 square theta will be equals to 3 minus root 5 upon 3 plus root 5. Okay, now for solving this part I have to rationalize it. Okay, so here I will multiply it by 3 minus root 5 upon 3 minus root 5. Okay, so here I will get 3 minus root 5 whole square upon 9 minus 5. Okay, so 1 upon 4 and 3 minus root 5 whole square. Now my 10 theta will be equals to what? I have to take the root. So I will get 1 by 2 3 minus root 5. Okay, this is my value of 10 theta. Now in the starting you have seen that in this part what I have considered, this value is 10 theta. Okay, I have considered this value as theta. So here I will write this value. Okay, I have considered it as what? 10 theta. Okay, my LHS. So add the from this. Okay, from this my theta is what? My theta is 10 inverse 3 minus root 5 by 2. Okay, so here I will put my value of theta. So it will be 10 inverse 3 minus root 5 upon 2. Okay, now your 10 and 10 inverse will cut and you will get 3 minus root 5 by 2. So this only my RHS is given. So I have to prove LHS equals to RHS. So here I can write my LHS equals to RHS and hence proved. Okay, so thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.